I'm very pleased to say I'm joined by Don Mcguiness, Talk Sports Don Mcguiness, what do we say? Manchester's
Don
Mcguiness.
Whatever you want, Chris.
For the, workout for the Groves-Eubank fight, great fight, Don. We've just seen them both there up close. We just spoke to Chris Senior, done an interview with him. How do you see this fight? How do you see them both? And it's really is a 50-50, we were saying before.
Yeah, it is. I mean, interesting when you look at them, and obviously with Chris coming out first to do his bit, you know, he looks smaller, obviously. He looks completely cut to ribbons. He looks as fit as a flea, which is his strength. Stamina, fitness, that relentless nature that he has. You can see him on the pads as well. You know, he wants to show off his speed, and that's what he's going to be all about. Then George Groves comes in after him, and again, he looks massive. He looks like he is making weight, whereas Chris Eubank looks like he could go for burger and chips now, and it's not going to be an issue whatever he does, because the size difference, it's like a light heavy versus a light middleweight almost, it looked like today. But will it matter? Obviously, Chris Senior, talking to him before, he's dismissing it out of hand that size will be any kind of factor. You think that's absolute nonsense. It's all to do with the spirit of the man. You can imagine how he elaborated on all that kind of stuff and made his points across. But, you know, they're super confident. Both lads are super confident. George Groves, just speaking to him now as well, he just feels that he's been there too many times. This isn't his biggest fight, he said. That was pretty much the standout point. I've been here before. It's his biggest fight. It's not mine. I'm just kind of cool about the whole thing. So let's see what happens on the night. But I know I'm going to win. That was Groves. Eubank Jr., again, not short of confidence. He's absolutely 100% sure he's going to have his hand raised at the end of that. And that's why it's a great fight. Yeah. We can talk all day about it and change your mind 50 times.
Yeah. And I could ask you 100 questions, but you know, the thing, I think what you hit on there, you know, Groves has got, he's been there, he's got that experience, very seasoned professional now, and Eubank's maybe not so much, but you know, you can't take away his confidence. So, you know, I mean, everything you said there is pretty much right.
You can spin everything on his head though, can't you? Because obviously Groves has got the experience, but has he had his time? Has he had his big night? Has he had his defining? Has he? Exactly. There's only a year between them in age, but Groves obviously vastly more experienced. So is it all? It's about timing, isn't it? Is it Eubank's time? He certainly thinks it is. He thinks he's the man on the up. Groves is the man on the dip. Therefore, it can be his night. So yeah, experience can work absolutely for you, of course. But if you've had too many tough fights, as we've seen before, you know, is it still there? You know, will he gas? Will he, the bigger man, the much bigger man on the night, gas against someone like Eubank, who will be on his chest all night? Again, it won't be long before we find out. But that's why it's so fascinating. So many questions.
Such an interesting fight. Yeah. It's great that it's happening as well. And this tournament, you know, that they're doing it in the World Boxing Series, has got them together. It's a really good format and a setup, isn't it?
Yeah.
We were saying earlier about, you know, the presenting it and giving the boxers the platform and getting the best fighting the best.
Well, it's brilliant, isn't it? I mean, the boxers are getting well paid. They're staying busy. They know. I mean, that was one of the criticisms of it when it started, is that they won't see this out. There's too many fights. It's too many big fights. No one's going to make it to the final. It was being spoken about May. Now it's going to be the 2nd of June, we understand, at the O2 in London. But it has worked. The cruiserweights have shown that it's worked brilliantly. Now, again, they're going to go into other divisions, no doubt about it as well. And I think everybody's going to want a piece of it. All the fighters are going to want to get on it for every reason. The production's great. They get well looked after, but it's a platform, and you can win world titles as well as the Muhammad Ali Trophy, and it's the best fight in the best, which is all that anyone that likes boxing wants to see, the best fight in the best. This format allows that to happen, and that's why it has been a big success, and Carlos Saulon's very, very pleased with himself.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I'm looking forward to it. I know you are, Don. If I had to put you right on the spot now and give us a brief prediction, what you're going to do, and I know
I can make a case for both lads. I can convince myself either way, but what I said initially when I was first asked this is that I feel that even though there's not much difference in age, there's a lot of difference in freshness, there's a difference in stamina and fitness. I'm going to go with the smaller man on this one. I'm going to go with the fitter man, and I just think that the relentless nature of Chris Eubank will win him the fight. I would imagine points. Again, if George does have any kind of stamina issues, he could stop him, but I think it will be Eubank on points. But I could change my mind 50 times between now and Saturday.
You don't say that with a lot of confidence.
Well, you're making me give a prediction. That will be my prediction, if you make me do it. But obviously, again, you can argue the other way around. But yeah, just that bit fresher, maybe a bit hungrier, it is his big night. He knows that it's a big, big chance for him to make a huge statement. There's a, you know, a lot at stake for him as well, getting to that final. So I'm going to go Eubank.
Good on the picture, because I don't know.
Well, not who does. Who does? That's why we're fascinated by it. Who does? We don't.
Tom, brilliant to speak to you, mate. Thanks, looking forward to it. Enjoy the fight.
See you at the press. See you Saturday.
See you there. All right, mate. All the best.